many campaigns, including, you remember all of you, Farah Louis campaign for city council, when we needed to endorse Farah Louis 3 times, in fact. So by the end of the day, it happened. So, but that's not the only race. We were always on the same page, and Rodneyse is a... Someone asked me, what can you say about Rodneyse Bichotte? I said, like, she can move tents, she can move houses, you know, like, she can move like, tons of people, you know. She has so many, so much energy and, you know, enthusiasm. It is exactly what we need in Brooklyn, you know, to show to the entire world that Brooklyn is a center of the universe. So, Rodneyse Bichotte.
Thank you, Ari. Thank you, Margarita. Thank you all for, thank you, Bay Democrats. Let's give Bay Democrats a round of applause. Thank you, everyone, for being here, to all of our judges. Good night, good evening.
Some of them are hiding there. But
some of them are hiding there. All the judges stand up so we can give a round of applause. Ari just talked about Farah. Farah's on her way. She just said, are you here? I said, yes.
So Farah Louis is coming.
Yeah, Farah Louis is coming. I just want to first thank you, Ari. Thank you, Margarita, for your support in this endeavor. I never expected to be the county leader, the Democratic county leader. I've just been focusing on helping other people. And I guess, you know, it was God's calling. And I'm really excited. I've been a district leader for 10 years, okay? 10 years, I've been an assemblywoman for 5 years now. And when I started as a district leader, we started together, right? 2010,
yes. Yeah. 2012.
And
Margarita, 2014.
Yes. You know, when I started as a district leader, I wasn't part of any group, okay? I didn't have my club. I wasn't part of the reform group. I wasn't part of the establishment. I was just me. Me and a group of people from my organization, my neighborhood, like Boris, who got together.
Who got together. Fancy.
Yeah, some fancy. Who got together and said, you know what? We want to be part of the democratic process. You know, we want to help make change. And how do we do this?
Sounds familiar, by the way.
Yeah, sounds familiar.
The story sounds familiar.
I think all of us was thirsting for change and how we could be part of this process. How could we make people be more engaged and vote for a person who's gonna represent us legitimately, who walks the same walk, who eats the same food, who suffers the same crisis. And so when I decided to run, no one supported me 10 years ago. They said, oh, who's this Haitian girl? It's very ethnic, you know. I'm like, why do they have to say I'm Haitian, you know? they said, who's this Haitian girl? She doesn't belong here. She shouldn't run. Well, I ran.
I showed them.
We supported for assembly, I remember. For assembly, we supported.
Yes, exactly. But what was interesting is, when I started this role, when I ran for district leader, I wasn't only looking at the black community. I wasn't only looking at the Haitian community. I included all of the communities. And that's what people didn't expect. And I remember when I went to the Jewish community, I went to the rabbi, Boris had introduced me, and we sat, he said, you know, you're good for this community. And he supported, and he endorsed me. And I went, and it was a very difficult race because I ran it against an incumbent who was the vice chair to Vito Lopez at that time. And I ran against the preferred choice for the assemblywoman who was Rhoda Jacobs. So yeah. I was by myself.
She was a great person. She's a great person.
Yes.
I worked with her for a long time.
Yes, and she was. And, her, you know, people thought her candidate was going to win because she was that person that everybody loved.
When she retired, there was a competitive election.
Right.
Two candidates came to us and we supported Rodneyse.
Yes. And so I won the district leader and then I ran in 2012 against Rhoda and then I lost. And then when she retired, I ran in 2014 and I got the support of Ari and many of you here and I won. And One of the things that I had decided to do immediately after I started my district leader in 2010 is to start a club, and I started the Shirley Chisholm Democratic Club. And for a very long time, that part of Brooklyn didn't have a club. It's exciting, we're happy, we started getting people to understand what county committee is. Now, has everybody filled out your county committee? Okay, okay, great, great. You know, these were little things that people didn't know about. So we're like getting county committee, we're getting judicial delegates, we're getting involved in how we're gonna process and screen the judges who are coming before us. And it made our district different. It changed because people felt that they were more inclusive. And when I was eventually elevated to the county leader, I said, that's what we want all of Brooklyn. We want all of Brooklyn to be involved and feel inclusive and be civically engaged because we want to be one voice. We want to be one strong party, a strong party so that any person running for election, whether it's federal, state, or local, they have to come to Brooklyn. They have to get the nod. Brooklyn, you know.
And the good with the bad
Exactly. Because we want like Brooklyn to be like the Iowa, right? Of New York State. Yeah. We're focused here.
Not so much on how our elections are.
But with a good act,
Well, we definitely won't rely on that.
What was the name of that act?
I don't even know. But we definitely don't want to
and we have
rely on
an app. By the way, we have in our club several people who work for Board of Elections. Please, Pierre, please stand up, please. Please.
Okay, good.
Co-workers? Yes. Oh. No, what co-workers? There's a board for Board of Elections.
Oh, okay.
Please. And Angie, we just gave you a reward. Angie, you work for Board of Elections? Why you can't do that? We just gave her a reward because she's helping elected hundreds of signatures. She's vice chairman, vice president of Marlboro House Sustainable.
Thank you for all that you do.
Yeah.
So now, where do we go from here?
Here, we're making club stronger, bigger, and we support candidates who deserve our support.
Exactly.
I would say it honestly, like we work together on Steven Mostovsky race. Mm-hmm. People saying everything is easy, like nothing is easy. To support a single judge, a single candidate for judge for any position, there are different opinions. We have 42 district leaders. Some people are saying like wrong color, wrong religion, wrong height, wrong gender. Like I'm saying, what about like legal education? What about like fairness? What about integrity? And you know, like we, several times we said, everybody supporting such a person was a, we don't support such a person because of integrity question. You know, it happened several times in the last like 10 years that we didn't support candidate because of integrity question,
right,
you know, like,
exactly.
Because especially judges, every person should have integrity, but judges, it's like before anything else, and if person is like, we see immediately coming to our club and starting like this negativity about colleagues, about, and like, we don't accept it, and I disagree with one of my colleagues who spoke badly about all judges and all district leaders at inauguration of a judge, you know, right. Whom I'm talking about, that's like, but my point is, like, we worked together on many campaigns, and before Margarita and I voted for Rodneyse Bichotte, one reporter called me from Bay News, how did you know that she would be a good chairperson? I said, are you kidding me? Do you know, like, member of the family, like, same, we live in the same apartment, we basically know everything. Like, we talk every day, we text every day, like, we campaign together on so many campaigns. Of course, I don't need introduction. You don't even talk, of course, no. I can talk about her more than she can talk about me. I made picture with carbon copy of Rodneyse Bichotte once. That was like 6 years ago, I believe.
Yes.
Because Rodneyse was late to the fundraiser and I made a picture with her carbon copy. You know? That's funny. Long story short, I'm sure that Rodneyse will be very inclusive. It's very important for us that like new chairman and new chairwoman now, I'm still saying chairman, you see? Chairwoman. By the way, you notice that one of the first clubs in Brooklyn she visited is Betty Amokhans. You just noticed this, yeah? It shows, again, respect, it shows attention. Brooklyn is a large, huge, almost 3 million people borough. and a lot of clubs, a lot of events every day. And besides, Rodneyse is Assemblywoman, so she has a lot of responsibilities. But she knows that, like, that our club matters and that you matters. It is very important. Not me, but you. Because without you, nothing will happen. You know, like, and we proved it over and over again with judges. We state senate, just Andrew Gounardes was here before. Like, it was like 1,200 votes difference, you know?
It was Farah.
Farah Louis came, you see? Everybody. Yeah, that's true. This is fourth time.
Fourth time. This is our club, too.
Yeah. Councilwoman Farah Louis, thank you for coming. Thank you. So, our district, by the way, is also. People say, oh, it's not a diverse district. It is a very diverse district. Listen, Brighton Beach, just listen, Brighton Beach, Manhattan Beach, Shipstead Bay, Homecrest, Midwood, Graves and Marlboro houses. It's a very, very diverse district. And usually candidate endorsed by our club wins not just like by 2, 5, 6 votes, but by large margin. It means all communities are together. We did a TV show, Brick. Maybe some of you participated. I know Irum participated. Jobova I invited, district leader. No, it was